Whenever you're ready, go ahead and begin.
Elegance is not standing out, but being remembered. Hello, I'm Grace Kelly. I was born on November 12, 1929 in Philadelphia, Pennsylvania, to Margaret Kelly and John Kelly Sr. My father was an Olympian and my mother was an athletic coach. I enjoyed reading, ballet, and theater as a child. I attended the American Academy of Dramatic Arts, where I studied to become an actress. I wanted a career on Broadway, but I found it difficult. As one of my directors and teachers quoted, she would never have had a career in the theater. She had great looks and style, but no vocal horsepower. I starred in many movies such as High Noon, Dial M for Murder, Rear Window, and Country Girl, for which I won the Academy Award in 1954. In 1955, while I was in Monaco filming a movie with Cary Grant, I met Prince Rainier Grimaldi III, the Prince of Monaco. Later in that same year, we announced our engagement. We were wed in Monaco, where about 600 people attended the wedding, and an estimated 30 million watched it. Soon after, we learned that we would be parents. During this time, I became known for the Kelly bag, as I used my purse to hide my pregnancies from the paparazzi. We have three children, Princess Caroline, Crown Prince Albert, and Princess Stephanie, born in 1957, 1958, and 1965. Many of my we lived in a 200-room palace that I tried to run like a normal house. I personally tended to my children's needs and cooked meals for my family. My humanitarian works began after my children were born. I served as president of the Garden Club of Monaco, of the Red Cross of Monaco, and of the organizing committee of the International Arts Foundation. Many of my humanitarian duties revolved around orphans. Each Christmas, I gave every orphan in Monaco personalized gifts. While my acting career didn't continue after becoming a princess, I continued my duties as a mother, princess, and humanitarian throughout the rest of my life. I suffered a stroke while driving with Princess Stephanie, and we crashed off a 45-foot cliff. While my daughter suffered minor injuries, I fell unconscious and died 2 days later on September 14th, 1982, following the removal of life support apparatus.